Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping with the difference between galvanic cell and electrolyte cell. So let's start. So if we talk about the galvanic cell, then it is an electrochemical cell that can produce electricity with the help of chemical reaction. So in the case of galvanic cell, what we do with the help of chemical reaction, we obtain electricity. But if we talk about the electrolyte cell, then it is a cell that uses electric current for progression of a chemical reaction. So for the execution of a chemical reaction, we make use of electric current, and that is obtained from the electrolyte cell. Next thing, if we talk about the galvanic cell, then it converts the chemical energy to electrical energy. So the chemical energy, or the energy for which we get from the chemical reaction, is converted into your electrical energy. But if we talk about the electrolyte cell, then it converts the electrical energy into chemical energy, just the opposite of what galvanic cell does. Next thing, if we talk about the galvanic cell, then it is a spontaneous reaction, or you can say it is a naturally occurring reaction which doesn't need a outside stimulus to start it. But if we talk about the electrolyte cell, then it is a non-spontaneous reaction. That means it needs an external stimulus to initiate it or to start it. Next thing, if we talk about the galvanic cell, then anode is negatively charged and cathode is positively charged. So the anode in your galvanic cell is negatively charged, whereas if we talk about the cathode is positively charged. But in the case of electrolyte cell, it is just opposite. That is, anode is positively charged and cathode is negatively charged. So this was all about the difference between galvanic cell and electrolyte cell. So if you like the video, please do the like button, do subscribing, and thanks for watching.